Hi, everyone. Welcome to JNUC. My name is Ellie Romero. I'm an enterprise support engineer here at Jamf. And today I will be covering our topic about automated device enrollment with virtual machines. So testing and deployment workflows are part of an admin's daily routine. Still, some workflows can involve longer than anticipated downtime than others. And the faster we can test, then the faster we can deploy. So here's when virtual machines can help us. But why use a virtual machine if you have available test machines? Snapshots. With snapshots, you can quickly start again under 1 minute. Still, faster than erase all content and settings on an M1 or waiting for macOS internet recovery. This course will cover configuring VM in parallel desktop or VMware Fusion to work again with automated device enrollment and user-initiated enrollment with Jamf or any MDM. Truly, any admin can benefit from this. So when enrolling a VM with either Parallels or VMware Fusion, you may run into several issues. For example, here we see that we have a status 500 error that the MDM was not able to be reached or the endpoint. Sometimes we may also see that the MDM profile will download install being missing, or with VMware Fusion, if it's not configured properly, you will be missing the profiles or not even interact with the remote management window at all. So here are all the prereqs that we're going to need for this workflow. We need a macOS, Big Sur or later. We're going to need a serial and model number of the device you're trying to spoof, an Intel Mac assigned an Apple School Manager or Business Manager, Parallel Desktop 17 with either Standard, Pro, or Business Edition, and VMware Fusion 12 with either Fusion Player, Personal Use License, or a Pro license. So a couple of things to keep in mind. The enrollment status of the test Mac does not affect the workflow, and the machines enrolled by this workflow should appear in Jamf after specified model in the device hardware model, but the architecture will be the same as the test machine, meaning an Intel Mac cannot spoof an M1 computer. Additionally, it will be best to delete the computer record in Jamf each time when you're reverting back to a pre-stage to test again. So now we're going to cover each app individually, and we're going to list a few of the steps followed by screenshots and then a quick demo of the workflow. So first, with Parallels, you want to ensure that the Mac is assigned to the pre-stage we're going to test in Jamf Pro. You're going to open Parallel Desktop next, and you're going to install macOS using the recovery partition. And once that has loaded, we will go ahead and turn off the VM. So why use install macOS from the recovery partition and not the app installer from the App Store? Fewer errors when creating the bootable disk image with the application. And why turn off the VM during the setup? In order to add the boot flags, we must power off the VM. It cannot be suspended. So once we pass the language selection and you're in the recovery window, go ahead and shut down the VM. Once powered off, we're going to head and open the settings for the VM so we can add the flags. Only two pieces of information that are needed, the serial number and the hardware model, that both can be found from system information from your Mac. All will go to the settings, hardware, boot order, and under advanced, you'll be able to add the flags. Here's an example using one of my test computers. All I added just those two flags in the previous slide. I added my information. As an optional IDM, you may want to configure the startup and shutdown behavior from the app so you can have more control when resuming the macOS installation. So once the flags are configured, just go ahead and restart the VM to continue with the macOS installation as normal. Halfway through, Once we've seen the Apple logo appear with the black screen and the progress bar and the timer showing how much time is left for the installation, you will want to turn off the Wi-Fi of the computer. Why turn off the Wi-Fi? Now, this is to avoid a virtual machine from communicating to the internet and the server before intended. For example, like automatically advance through Setup Assistant and macOS 11 or later. This will also ensure that we get the cleanest snapshot and the macOS install will complete. No worries there. Once the installation is complete, make sure to go ahead and take a snapshot and then go ahead and turn Wi-Fi back on in the computer to continue with the enrollment. Here's a quick example, just creating the snapshot. And then, again, once you turn Wi-Fi back on and proceed, you will be able to see the remote management window, unlike the first error we saw, which is the remote management 500 error. So now let me show you a quick demo of putting everything in practice and how it works as well as restoring from a snapshot. So in the video, we're going to be deploying Jamf Connect via PreStage. We're going to go through the entire macOS Setup Assistant until we see the Jamf Connect login window. And then we're going to restore back to a snapshot until we see the remote management window again. As you can see, the VM is going through the enrollment as normal as intended. It's connecting to the server, downloading all the profiles and packages that are scoped to my PreStage. Okay, almost done. So once complete, again, we'll go through the final steps through the setup, and we should see the Jamf Connect login window. And there's Jamf Connect, as expected. And to revert to snapshot, do it from the menu bar. And again, under a minute, I can go back to square one and test again. And just like that, ready to deploy. Next, we're going to cover VMware Fusion. Very similar to Parallel Desktop, we'll have a few of the steps on the slide, followed by screenshots of the workflow, then a quick demo video towards the end. Similar, do you want to make sure that the machine is assigned to the PreStage in Jamf Pro? You're going to open VMware Fusion and select install from disk or image. Then during the setup, we'll want to make sure to customize settings before finishing the setup. So when you open VMware Fusion, you go ahead and select Install Desk or From Image. Unlike Parallel Desktop, fewer errors with VMware Fusion when using any of the app installers downloading from the App Store. So here you can use either method. When you see this window, again, you want to go ahead and click Customize Settings instead of Finish. This will be so that we can find the VMware file and edit so we can add a similar template like we did with Parallels Desktop. So again, we're going to navigate through Finder. We're going to find the .vmx file so we can edit the file with any text editor application that you prefer. Keep in mind that the path may change depending where you save it, the file, but here's an example for my computer. Once I find the .vmx file, again, I open the app or the file with any text editor app. Now the template here, so you can see it's a little bit longer, but we still only need just two components, the serial number and the hardware model. Both, again, can be found from system information. When you're editing the text file, you want to make sure to add the template to the very last end of the file. Add the two values, again, serial number and hardware model, and then save the file. Everything else in the template will stay the same. After making the edits to the .vmx file, go ahead and save it, then restart the VM to continue the macOS installation. Similar to Parallels, once we see the black screen with the Apple logo and the timer for the installation, you want to turn off the Wi-Fi of the computer. Again, the macOS installation will complete. This is to avoid the virtual machine from communicating to the internet and the server before intended, and it will ensure that we get the cleanest snapshot. So once the macOS installation is complete, go ahead and take a snapshot and then turn back on the Wi-Fi for the computer. And here's a quick example of how to create a snapshot from the menu bar. Once created, again, turn Wi-Fi back on and proceed with enrollment as normal. So now here we have another quick demo of putting everything together. Just like with Parallels, we're gonna go through the enrollment and we're gonna deploy Jamf Connect and then revert back to the snapshot. As any enrollment, this will take a couple minutes, but as you guys can see, it is communicating with the server and it is downloading all the profiles and packages scoped to that pre-stage. Almost there. We should see one or two more windows for macOS Setup Assistant, the ones allowed from the pre-stage, and then we should see the Jamf Connect login window. And here it is, Jamf Connect, the login window starting to load. Perfect. And now we're just going to revert back to the snapshot we took earlier. And just like that, in a matter of just seconds, maybe a minute, I'm back to square one and ready to test again. It's a pretty simple workflow and setup for both applications. It will not take super long, but it's super helpful for any admin, save time during testing. Now, any questions you guys may have? If no questions, thank you all for listening and enjoy JNUC.